Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. Today I will discuss about severe combined immunodeficiency, that is SCID. Severe combined immunodeficiency was first described by Dr. Odin Bruton in 1952 when he reported a case of a young boy with recurrent infections and the absence of serum gamma globulin. This condition, now known as X-linked A-gamma globulinemia, was the first described form of SCID immunodeficiency. However, the specific condition, now known as SCID, was first more clearly defined in 1950s and 1960s through the work of various immunologists, including Dr. Robert A. Good, who in 1959 reported cases of infants with a complete lack of immune system. Severe combined immunodeficiency is a group of rare inherited disorders characterized by a severely compromised immune system. Individuals with SCID have little to no immune response due to profound defects in both T and B lymphocytes, the white blood cells essential for fighting infection. It is called combined because it affects both arms of the adaptive immune system, the cell-mediated response and the humoral response. People with SCID have defect in both of these cell types, leading to a severely weakened immune response. On the basis of gene mutation and inheritance pattern, SCID is classified into three forms. First one is X-linked SCID, is the most common form caused by mutation in the IL2RG gene, leading to a lack of functioning T cells and NK cells. Autosomal recessive SCID includes forms caused by mutations in the ADA, that is Adenosine Deaminase gene, RAG1, RAG2 gene, and others. Other rare forms are also involving mutations in JAK3, IL7R, and other genes affecting immune cell development. SCID is estimated to occur in approximately 1 in 40,000 to 1 in 1 lakh live births worldwide. X-linked SCID is the most common form of SCID and accounts for about 50 to 60% of all cases. X-linked SCID affects males primarily and occurs in about 1 in 50,000 to 1 in 1 lakh male births. Symptoms of SCID include frequent severe infections such as respiratory infection, ear infection, skin infection, fungal infection, and digestive tract infection. Fail to grow or gain weight as expected, a condition called cellulitis, lymphopenia, and delayed growth and development. Infants may not meet developmental milestones. Severe combined immunodeficiency can result from mutation in several different genes, all of which play crucial roles in the development and function of the immune system, like ADA, that is Adenosine Deaminase, RAG1 and RAG2, that is Recombination Activating Genes 1 and 2, IL2RG, that is Interleukin-2 Receptor Gamma Chain, IL7R, Interleukin-7 Receptor Alpha, JAK3, Janus Kinase 3, GCLRE1C, that is Artemis, and NHEJ1, that is Non-Homologous End Joining 1 or etc. IL2RG gene is located on long arm of X chromosome at position 13.1, consists of 8 exons, and size of gene is 4.2 kb and encodes 369 amino acid long protein. ADA1 gene is located on long arm of chromosome 20 at position 13.2, consists of 12 exons and size of gene 32.7 kb. While SCID is a rare condition, early diagnosis and treatment are crucial for affected individuals. The expanding use of newborn screening has played a vital role in identifying SCID cases early, leading to better management and outcomes. The diagnosis of SCID involves a combination of clinical evaluation, family history, and laboratory tests. Complete blood count, that is CBC, is a common finding of lymphopenia. Flow cytometry can measure the levels of different immune cells, T cell, B cell, and NK cells. A lack of T cell is a hallmark of SCID. Immunoglobulin levels test, which determine the functionality of immune system. In SCID patients, typically have very low level of immunoglobulin, particularly IgG, IgA, and IgM. Confirmatory tests such as genetic sequencing is crucial for a definitive diagnosis. Once SCID is diagnosed, genetic counseling is essential for families, especially since some forms of SCID are inherited and can recur in future generations. Therapy for severe combined immunodeficiency aims to restore the immune system's ability to fight infections and improve the overall health and survival of the patient. Treatment options include immunoglobulin replacement therapy, enzyme replacement therapy, hematopoietic stem cell transplant, bone marrow transplant, and platelet. Immunoglobulin replacement therapy is used to provide passive immunity and prevent infection. Immunoglobulin replacement therapy is used to supply antibodies that the patient is unable to produce due to a dysfunctional immune system. This is essential in the management of SCID until definitive treatments like hematopoietic stem cell transplant or gene therapy, it can restore immune function. While immunoglobulin replacement therapy provides protection against infection, it is not a long-term solution and must be continued until the immune system recovers. Enzyme replacement therapy for ADSCID aims to replace the missing enzyme adenosine deaminase in ADA deficient. Enzyme replacement therapy involves regular intravenous infusion of ADA enzyme, which helps to reduce toxic metabolites that damage immune cells in ADSCID patients. Enzyme replacement therapy is often used in combination with other treatments such as hematopoietic stem cell transplant. ERT can stabilize patients and improve immune function, but it doesn't fully restore normal immune system. Hematopoietic stem cell transplant aims to replace the defective immune system with a functional one. Hematopoietic stem cell transplantation involves transplanting stem cells from a healthy donor into the patient. These stem cells can repopulate the bone marrow and produce normal immune cells. Early HSCT offers the best chance for long-term survival and immune recovery. Graft versus host disease, infections, and immune reconstitution issues can occur, but these risks can be managed with medications and supportive care. Gene therapy aims to correct the genetic defect causing SCID, the future of the SCID patient. Gene therapy involves extracting the patient's own stem cells, correcting the stem genetic mutation in the laboratory, and then transplanting the corrected cells back into the patient. This aims to restore normal immune function without the risk of rejection associated with a donor transplant. Gene therapy has shown promising results, especially for certain forms of SCID, that is X-linked SCID caused by IL2RB mutation. However, safety concerns related to insertional mutagenesis and long-term efficacy are still under study. The choice of therapy depends on the specific type of SCID, the patient's condition, and the availability of suitable donors or therapy. Early intervention is crucial to improve survival rates and quality of life. This is all about severe combined immunodeficiency. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family to spread awareness. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you very much.